गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स. लास्ट क्लास आई हैव स्टार्टेड न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स यूनिट इन डाइवर्सिटी एंड पी पोर्शन आई हैव कंप्लीटेड. सो नाउ द थर्ड पोर्शन डांस एंड म्यूजिक. आई टोल्ड यू लास्ट क्लासेस फ्यू पार्ट आई हैव डन. सो द डांस एंड म्यूजिक आई टोल्ड यू दैट टू काइंड्स ऑफ डांसेस वी हैव सीन इन आवर कंट्री क्लासिकल एंड फोक डांस. एंड व्हाट इज क्लासिकल एंड व्हाट इज फोक डांस आई एक्सप्लेन्ड लास्ट क्लासेस. सो नाउ द रेस्ट पोर्शन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. द पोर्शन इज दैट इंडियन म्यूजिक लाइक द डांस फॉर्म्स ऑल्सो गोज बैक टू द वेदास. There are two main schools of classical music. The North Indian school is called Hindustani and the South Indian school is called the Carnatic. So in Vedic period you have seen that there are two types of schools, classical music. So the North Indian school, North Indian school is called Hindustani and South Indian school called Carnatic. In Indian music we have the Gharana tradition. In music we have seen Gharana type of tradition. Students learn music from guru by living in his house. So Gharana type of music that where the students of learned music from his guru. And devotional music such as couplets by Kabir and bhajans by Surdash, Tulsidas and Mirabai are sung all over the country. And bhajan type of music we have sung by Mirabai, Tulsidas, Surdas. So Indian folk music consists of traditional songs sung during festivals and weddings. And also at the time of festivals and weddings we have heard the Indian folk music a traditional type of song we have heard at the time of festivals and weddings. So art and now the next heading is art and sculpture. The earliest form of art based on the teachings of the Buddha are the cave painting at Ajanta and Ellora in Maharashtra. So earliest form based on the teachings of Buddha. So teaching of Buddha, advices of the Buddha we have learned from the cave paintings, and this type of paintings are seen at Ajanta and Ellora, which is situated in Maharashtra. Miniature art is seen in Pahari, Rajput and Mughal paintings. Earlier craftsmen built beautiful monuments. So that time of craftsmen also expert, and they built beautiful monuments and places of worship. So as for example, we can see that the stupas of Sanchi were built by Emperor Ashoka and the Taj Mahal by Shah Jahan. The latter is now recognized as one of the wonders of the world. The latter means the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is recognized one of the wonders of the world. Many famous monuments and buildings are a part of our heritage. Now next point is food. The food grains, vegetables and fruits grown in our country vary from place to place depending upon the landform, climate and season. What is said? This is said that food crops, food grains, food means the wheat, paddy, these are the food crops or food grains, vegetables, different types of vegetables and fruits grown in our country, but they vary. They vary means the changes. So in different places you have seen different types of food crops, different types of vegetables, different types of fruits. Because why different types? Because this depends on the landforms and climate and season. So variation we have seen. Spices such as chilies, turmeric, pepper, cardamom and cloves are grown. Sweets such as rasgulla, srikhand, pasham and laddus are popular in India. This type of sweets are popular in our India. So now the next point is clothes. Land and climate also determine the dress worn by the people of an area. Some parts are covered with thick forest and some areas are near the sea. In some parts, summers are very hot and winters are very cold, while in other parts, the climate is almost the same throughout the year. what is said? Clothes. Clothes means that we have seen that in our country, in different states, different places, people wear different types of dresses. Why? Because the climatic changes, weather changes. We have seen that in some parts in our country are covered with thick forest, some areas near the sea, and some parts summers we feel very hot and some areas very cold areas. So depend the variation of weather and climate, so that's why the dresses also changes. So people wear different types of dresses. The popular dresses in our country are salwar kameez with a dupatta in Punjab, ghagra kurta with an orni in Haryana, ghagra kachli in Rajasthan, lehenga choli in Gujarat, and mundu blouse in Kerala. Men generally wear trousers and shirts. Other dresses for men are pajama kurta, dhoti kurta, lungi kurta or lungi shirt. Men in Rajasthan wear churidar kurta with an achkan or angrakha and a churidar with a jacket is worn in Gujarat. So different places, different dresses we have learned now. In Tamil Nadu, men's lungis are called vesti and in Kerala they are called mundu. Men in West Bengal and Assam mostly wear dhoti kurtas. Even the style of tying the turban differs from state to state. In the hilly regions, due to the cold, the Kashmiris wear a long woolen kurta called firan. So we have learned from this paragraph that the different people wear different dresses because it depends on the climatic changes or weather changes. So they wore different type of dresses. So you have to keep in mind in which places what type of dresses the people wear. So at the time of examination it may ask. So now today up to this, and next day I will continue the next portion. The point is unity. Thank you.